hip strap on the backpack.
Yeah, actually.
Kiwis.
So after another late start, we ended up finding ourselves out on Lake Makara with a fairly strong headwind. Now this made travel pretty hard going, so it was decided as a group that the best call was to pack up the rafts, and we were going to hike alongside the lake on what's known as Demon Trail. We thought this would be the easiest option. Now with a name like Demon Trail, we probably should have known it wasn't going to be easy. We couldn't even find the trail for quite a while, but eventually we did, and we didn't get anywhere near as far as what we had planned. And so we ended up having to call it quits early that day, which then put our timings out of whack for the rest of the trip, where we had to match up sections with the correct tide, and it just made our life a lot harder than it had to be. When we were planning this trip originally, it was decided that on this day we'd try and make about a 5 a.m. start to get down the lake, because it's well known these strong headwinds come up later in the afternoon, and this simply just didn't end up working out for us. We ended up spending longer than we'd planned on the first day packing the car, and so everything was out of timing. And so therefore, later on in the trip, we had an incoming tide when we should have had an outgoing tide, and it made it very, very difficult to travel.
Whoa! That cool. They were really big.
There's my ride. That's where we come from. That's where we're going.
Look at my boot.
I'm
That's why. That's not a great option. Okay, hang on, hang on.
Sorry.
Your door is just down 6 inches.
Hang on, yep, I might need to
and try and get.
How's the gamble working out?
Not well.
When we were planning this trip originally, one of the dangers that kept coming up in everything we read was the dangers of crossing Mackenzie Creek in higher levels, and the fact that it's very treacherous, or can be treacherous, and you may even need to inflate your raft to get across it. We weren't really sure what to expect. In some of the huts that we stayed in, there were further warnings about it, and so we thought this was going to be a really big event. It turned out to be a bit of an anticlimax when we got there, and we could pretty much almost jump across it, which was good for us, but you could definitely see the potential. If there was higher river levels, this would be a significant challenge to get across, and you probably would have to inflate your rafts and head upstream to a safer place.
Here we are. 15 hours.
They preset the fire ready to go. It's so
good. Super peaceful.
So once we got down on the coast at Big Bay, we came across a local guy called Warwick who does remote surfing and hunting tours. And he kindly gave us an offer to take our packs and rafts up the track where we were heading to save us a bit of work. But unfortunately, due to the rough track, we actually snapped a paddle blade, which made paddling down the next river on the Pike River pretty tough, to say the least. He also gave us some venison meat, which after living on dehydrated food for so long, was a welcome relief.
Onto the second river.
Eventually we got to the Pike River. It took us a lot longer than we were expecting to get here, but we were so stoked to be here. The river was a lot lower than we were expecting as well, which wasn't the end of the world, but it did mean that there was a fair bit of bum scraping across rocks on the first half. But it was so much better than walking, and we're all really excited to be back,
up back
on the river and finally making some decent progress.
That's your stick. Oh, 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 oh.
I'm going backwards.
And I miss you most when the sunlight filters across these empty sheets and days in the sun with the cold on the cheeks.
How clear is it?
And everything we need, love, I can feel in my bones.
Stick left.
Days in the sun, nights under the streets, and I'm singing to my mother, singing to the sea. Say, I've been singing to my father, singing to the trees, singing to the things that help us breathe. The days in the sun, I hope these days are.
Yeah, for this one at least.
What?
Let me go.
We're back. We're scraping.
But everything we need, love, I can feel.
Yeah, go for it.
Days in the sun, nights under the streets, and I'm singing to my mother, singing to the sea. See, I've been singing to my father, singing to the tree, singing to the things that help us me. Days in the sun, nights under the streets, and I'm singing to my mother, singing to the sea. See, I've been singing to my father, singing to the tree,
so close.
Singing to the things that help us.
I know, I had a
suction. These days are always, are always the best with you.
Yes, exactly. You look impressed. Yeah, that's what's gonna follow us. All that.
And reverse. Uh-oh. Don't tip.
Oh, that's amazing. good or not?
Amazing.
Smell it.
We really need to stop.
Yeah, I know.
We could all have one sip.
So when we were chatting with Warwick down at Big Bay, he mentioned a guy called Bruce. So Bruce is a local guy, just lives completely alone by himself out in the wilderness, and we just happened to bump into him here on Lake Alabaster. So Bruce gave us a bit of a warning about the weather coming in, and he was pretty right. So that night we had a fairly decent storm, probably small for fjordland, but from what we were used to it was massive, and the lake and the rivers rose a significant level. So the next day was pretty interesting.
Getting a bit windy. Whoa.
So we're caught out on Lake Alabaster as the storm was starting to come in a little bit earlier than forecast. There were strong winds coming up, there was a lot of chop, there was a lot of rain, and we were all feeling pretty vulnerable out on the lake in our pack rafts with a 30 kilo pack up the front. They tend to steer from the bow, and it's not very ideal conditions to be out in, so we were all very keen to get to the hut and warm up and dry out before the storm came in properly. And fortunately we did, but it also marked a bit of a change in the trip. We're starting to bump into other people, it was a little bit more popular, and so we all sort of wished we could go back a couple of the days prior to where it was true wilderness, there was no one else around and it was just us.
Just a gentle breeze.
I know, they're decent. Here we go, here's a good one. Decent swell.
Oh, he's got it.
Oh, man. Yeah.
dangling. Oh, no drums.
They are winning that.
Where she start? What a machine.